You're watching Fox 29. This is Good Day Philadelphia.
It has been 7 days since Terry Schiavo has been given food or any water, and the severely brain-damaged Huntington Valley native seems to be slipping away now. In the years leading up to this controversial move, many have questioned the motives of Terry's husband, Michael, whispering about a large payment he might receive upon her death. It comes from a medical malpractice lawsuit. Patients' rights attorney Tom Klein is here. He handles these types of lawsuits all the time. Good morning, Tom.
I sure do, Jen. Good morning. Good Friday.
Thank you. You as well. So what actually happened in that MedMal case? Bring us up to date.
Terry Schiavo was a bulimic. She went to her gynecologist. Her complaints were that she had problems with her menstrual cycle. He examined her. He saw that she had these terrible stretch marks. He didn't ask any questions. He didn't do the proper history. And a jury ultimately found he was responsible. Interestingly, the jury found Terry, was 70% responsible. He was 30% responsible. And under Florida law, there was an award of money. That money ultimately went into a trust. The guardian, unopposed by the parents, was Michael Schiavo. And therein lies the rub today.
Explain the difference, because if this would have happened, or if they were living here in Pennsylvania, the outcome of this money or where it would go would be different than it is now, because the couple does live in Florida, correct?
Yes, Jen. Interestingly, there are differences in different state laws that apply. Here in Pennsylvania, if you do not have a will and you die and you're married and have parents, the parents and the spouse share equally, essentially. In fact, I had a case just like that involving substantially more money than the Schiavo case. And as you might expect, there sometimes are controversies and issues that arise between the parents and the spouse. In Florida, the spouse, under the law, takes everything. So the parents are shut out, and what will remain from the money, what will remain from the medical malpractice money in the trust, will go to the spouse, in this case, Michael.
If you know the answer to this question, but it was $1 million, not very much money. She's been under serious medical care for quite some time. How can there be any money left at this point?
Well, that's an interesting question, and it's a matter of dispute. Actually, I went on the internet last night and was looking around, and I saw that there's a whole controversy about how much money Michael spent and how much it remains. The fact of the matter is the jury found, interestingly, that she was only going to live for 17 years, and while they found the doctor negligent, they didn't award a lot of money to take care of someone. In fact, not enough money to take care of her for her lifetime. In the case of a woman in her condition, it takes literally a few $100,000 a year to take care of her. So there isn't much money left, according to some accounts, but there's clearly some money. And knowing this case and knowing the situation, there'll be something for lawyers and the parties to fight about.
We're running up on a nine. We have to get to weather. But the one last question I have, can the parents sue Michael for wrongful death for discontinuing this life support?
I can't see how that could be, Jen, or how that at least could be successful. The fact of the matter is that in this case, he got a court order. He did all of the right things. He went to court. Ultimately, the court sanctioned it, and I can't see a basis for suing Michael Schiavo.
All right, Tom Klein, thanks for doing some research for us. We do appreciate it.
Nice to be here.
You as well.